At SAP, our mission for asset and service management is simple: to help the world's assets run better. In industries where every operational decision impacts entire supply chains, our solutions are transforming the ways companies manage their assets, ensuring they operate smarter, more efficiently, and with sustainability top of mind. Asset and service management capabilities from SAP are deeply embedded in the core ERP suite, with solutions for asset performance, field service, mobility, and others, complementing ERP to support advanced use cases. The suite enables closed-loop business process orchestration, integrating data and AI to optimize asset life cycles, automate workflows, and unlock value in maintenance and service programs. Asset management does not operate in isolation. It impacts the entire organization's supply chain, financials, and bottom line. With SAP Asset and Service Management embedded in the core ERP suite, we break down silos and ensure it's fully integrated into business processes and data. Keep in mind, SAP covers the entirety of the asset lifecycle and incorporates this into closed-loop systems that drive continuous improvement for maintenance and service organizations. Now that we have covered the basics, let's take a look at the system and how we deliver value with our solution capabilities and end-to-end business processes. I start on my Fiori Launchpad, which is my single point of entry for all solution areas. The user experience is designed to help users get their work done more easily, providing a UX that is intelligent, consistent, and integrated across all SAP applications. I've personalized my Launchpad to be tailored to the applications that I use most. Let's start by looking at strategic asset management planning. As a maintenance planner, I want to calculate component and resource requirements, that is, spare parts and workforce, for medium to long-term planning horizons for my asset-intensive industry. Moreover, the system empowers me to estimate financial costs for components and resources, and allows me to perform maintenance cost budgeting, breaking down silos between finance and asset management teams. AI simplifies the integration of supply chain data with maintenance, and in this scenario, supports the identification and resolution of bottlenecks. Joule detects the missing parts for upcoming planned maintenance, allowing further investigation, adjustments to plans, and supports a resilient supply chain. We facilitate asset master data in collaboration to centralize the asset management ecosystem onto a single collaboration platform. This allows asset data and the digital thread to be managed across several parties, enabling collaboration within a common asset taxonomy. The same applies for collaborative maintenance, where work can be digitally shared with service providers on a unified portal. Let's take a look at how we revolutionize asset performance with asset reliability engineering and asset health monitoring. As a reliability engineer, I am responsible for categorizing assets and prioritizing critical equipment by employing a risk-based maintenance approach. This involves assessing multiple factors, including the likelihood of failure and its potential consequences. As part of asset reliability engineering, I must define and implement maintenance strategies. While there are several different methodologies to do this, here I carry out an RCM assessment on a technical object, where I have assigned failure data and have assigned the corresponding recommendations. Lastly, asset health monitoring is performed to detect anomalies and predict failures proactively. This process identifies abnormal patterns and potential equipment failures, which then trigger alerts. Here we can also incorporate AI-enabled visual inspection, which allows for condition-based maintenance based on image data. Let's delve into the area of planning, scheduling, and dispatching, where I will start as a maintenance planner. First, a maintenance notification has been generated based on an alert being triggered from a high bearing temperature. Now, using SAP Business AI, I get order recommendations based on historical maintenance data to assist me in planning the request. Based on the score, I select the first option and copy the relevant data to the new order. Following this AI-enabled workflow, I open up the order and have a view of the planned operations and costs, which I will then use as a basis for planning. After creating the order, I check my work center capacities, utilization, and resource needs to ensure that I can meet all of the upcoming demands. I can view this in several different formats, such as in months, weeks, and view by several different criteria based on my preferences. For high-volume operations, dynamic AI scheduling can be used to automate assignments and improve resource utilization. This approach ensures optimized scheduling assignments and allows dispatchers to focus on more detailed and complex tasks. For example, as a dispatcher, I use natural language filtering to identify emergency orders within a specific high-risk area requiring immediate attention. This AI-enhanced workflow quickly locates these orders, or any other orders relevant to my search criteria. Next, I open up the order and generate an AI equipment summary, detailing completed work, spare parts used, equipment condition, and other relevant information which is useful in dispatching or execution. Before finalizing, I review job duration predictions for realistic estimates, apply custom scheduling policies, and assign the task to Raoul Johns based on SLA compliance. For numerous organizations, utilizing a map for dispatching provides an essential visual reference necessary for managing distributed assets or service appointments. To support resource optimization and sustainability efforts, we provide predictive routing capabilities designed to enhance routing efficiency and reduce CO2 emissions, all while providing an interactive map interface for dispatching. With jobs now assigned, we shift focus to the mobile workforce, particularly the field technician. The app can be accessed both online and offline, while featuring a configurable user interface and allowing for personalized views based on technician preference. I have quick action buttons, and key information is logically structured for easy access and attention. When starting my day, I get a quick view of my work directly from the map. I open up the high priority work order near me and get to work. From the work order screen, I have all the key information I need to guide me to job completion. First step is equipment checklist, where I will go and perform some quick tests, and then decide if any further action is required. Returning to the work order, I proceed to work on the order operations. This operation requires me to take some readings on the equipment, and I proceed to take all of the measurements. Next, I will conduct testing and diagnostics to help identify the issue. I follow the 3D instructions provided to safely disassemble the pump and perform the necessary checks. Before completing the job, I also document my findings in a digital form and record any required signatures. Lastly, I post my final time confirmations and submit the work order for review to my supervisor, which then updates the corresponding workflow step. SAP excels at creating closed-loop asset management systems, meaning every piece of data feeds back into the system, enabling continuous improvement. Let's start by returning to the completed work order, which provides a full history of costs and parts used, damage and cause codes, planned versus actuals, and much more, aiding in strategic maintenance decisions. SAP excels at combining self-service analytics with master and transactional data to drive informed decision-making. Here we examine maintenance cost by order and can easily switch between variants to quickly view different reports and drill into the relevant data. Here I can see damages and corrective activities associated with cause codes, their frequency, and what part is it associated with. According to the report, corrosion is reported the most, and associated with the part code of bearings. Now examining our functional occasions, we can analyze breakdowns on individual technical objects or on a more macro level and identify the causes of these failures. Using this data and noting the excessive failures, I will proceed to create a strategy assessment and develop the recommendations to improve asset reliability. In this short demo, we quickly examined how SAP unifies connected processes with closed-loop systems, unifies asset and ERP data, and unlocks insights and automates business processes with AI, all with the goal of helping the world's assets run better. Thousands of customers worldwide use SAP Asset and Service Management. Here are examples of its quantitative impact on some of these organizations. Ready to unlock value in your asset and service management programs? Let's get in touch or check out sap.com/EAM.